G'day. You don't always need to see or feel the difference. G'day. If you've followed me for a while now, you may have noticed that in recent months, I've actually lost quite a bit of weight. And indeed, a number of you have reached out to me and made that observation to me. And a few people have said that I must feel so much healthier now, I must feel so much better now. And of course, logically, I want to say yes, but I don't know that I actually felt that much worse before. And I don't know that I feel that much better today. And if you think about most people who answer that question and say, yes, I feel great now, it's often in the context of things like, you know, now I can go and kick the football with the kids for a bit longer, or I can go for that walk with the dog without getting puffed out. But I don't have those activities as part of my daily routine. And so, if anything, I kind of find I feel more tired now than I did before, because every morning I hit the park, I pump out my 13 plus kilometers every day, I come back and I'm knackered because I've never done that for a long, long time. And so, if anything, I'd probably argue that I even feel more tired perhaps today than I did back then. But the fact is, it doesn't matter, because whether I look better and whether I feel better, I know that in losing a bit of weight, in doing a bit more exercise, in having a healthier heart function, a healthier lung function, a healthier blood flow, circulation, all of these things will make me healthier in the long run. And so, or even the short run for that matter. And so the vanity metric, if you like, and this is where it becomes, I think, a bit interesting, the vanity metric of how I look doesn't really matter. And even the vanity metric internally of how I feel doesn't matter. I just know that it's better for me. And it's a bit like the social media vanity metrics we talk about, I think, where, you know, we think about our likes and our shares and our comments that we get on our posts. And if we don't get enough of them, we get concerned. And that's the vanity metric of social media. But you don't know how just one post, just one comment, just one video, just one text, just one photo can make a difference to somebody. They may not like it, they may not share it, they may not comment on it, but it might have just been what they needed on that day and on that time. And certainly that's what I found over the years of doing this show. I've had people reach out to me that weren't really connected to me. I didn't know that they were following me. They'd never commented, liked, or shared. And they just made a comment that sort of said to me personally, that particular post really helped me, or I really appreciate that point of view, or I'd never thought about that. That put me on a different thought process myself. And so I think the bottom line here is, whether it's the online vanity metrics or the real life vanity metrics, and let's face it, having somebody say that you've lost weight and you look so much better is probably the ultimate vanity metric in a way. It actually doesn't matter. None of that stuff matters. So don't get obsessed about the vanity metrics. Don't get obsessed about how you look and even how you feel in that sense. Get obsessed about the fact that you know it's making a difference somewhere, somehow it's helping you. And that's all that matters. It's the internal validation versus the external validation. Just thought I'd throw that in. Alrighty, that is it for today. I do thank you for your time, and I will be back again tomorrow. See ya.